What's happening everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back. So after many years of checking out 3D printing videos on YouTube, I finally got my own 3D printer. So this right here, it's called the AnkerMake M5. And I'll be honest, before I got this printer, I knew nothing about 3D printers. I've just seen those videos online and it always seemed a bit complicated to print anything because it does seem like a lot to learn. But after using this for a couple of weeks, I'm actually confident I can print pretty much anything with it. Just to give you an example how easy it is to get used to something like this, my 11-year-old daughter, after seeing me do stuff on this for a couple of days, now she knows how to download her own projects, she knows how to print her own projects. This is actually something that she printed the other day, and this, and she has a whole bunch of things planned to print. Since this was one of our first attempts, some flaws have appeared in some areas without supports due to overhangs. However, even with the small imperfections, we are pretty happy with the end result. But what we learned from this is the fact that we have to use supports when dealing with models that have overhangs. So I'm assuming that many beginners like myself aren't aware that adding supports will greatly improve the quality of prints. So if you're just starting out with a 3D printer, definitely research supports. So it is surprisingly easy to get going with a printer like this. So in today's video, I'm gonna go over my experience as a first-time 3D printer owner, basically. Alright, so even though the printer does look quite complex, putting this together takes about 15 minutes, maybe even less than that. You basically have to put some screws at the bottom here, connect some cables and a few more screws on this side here. So it is surprisingly easy to put this together out of the box. Now, there is a user manual that comes in the box and there are step-by-step instructions. I highly recommend that you follow the step-by-step instructions. Personally, I haven't done that when I took this out of the box, and then I kind of had to put it back in the box and follow the instructions. So I highly recommend that you check out the instructions in the user manual to put this together, but it is super simple to do, much simpler than I ever imagined. In the box, you're also gonna find this little toolbox here. This could come in handy in some situations, and you're also gonna find some startup filament kit, let's call this. So you're gonna find one of these. However, you probably wanna get yourself one of these bigger ones, because once you start printing, you're not gonna wanna stop printing. It is quite entertaining to make all these things. So you're gonna run out of this pretty quick. As always, I will leave some links in the video's description to check out the printer and some 3D printing filament for the printer. The printer itself is very well built. We have a combination of metal and some plastic, and I also love the fact that this doesn't look clanky like a lot of 3D printers that I've seen online. This actually makes really cool office art, I'm gonna say. So I'm definitely gonna keep this in my office because it does look super cool, aside from being a very functional printer as well. Aside from looking awesome, this is also a very fast printer, and this is a very important thing for a 3D printer. So this prints with a speed of 500 millimeters per second with a 0.1 millimeter precision. So good quality prints and also fast prints, so this will cut the printing times by 80%. Of course, each project is different and each project will take different times. Just to give you an example, this here is done about 17 minutes and 40 seconds, if I remember right, but you can get projects that will last many hours. Now, a very important feature. So on the side here, we have a camera. You can actually check through the AnkerMake app and see exactly what that camera sees. So you can actually see the printer in action if you just leave this at home and you have a project going, and basically you're not gonna be right next to the printer. So you can check and see the live view of what that camera sees. And of course, you can also control the printer from the app. But what's interesting, because you may not always have the time to keep an eye on the printer, so this has AI error detection. So if it will detect something that doesn't go according to plan, it will actually stop the print itself. So a very important feature, because if you have a big project and this is gonna last for many hours, if you don't have that camera with AI error detection, that could go, like if the project goes bad, basically, it will not stop it if you wouldn't have a camera like this. So at least like this, you're not gonna waste all that filament, all that time and so on. So a very important feature, having that the ability to basically stop itself if it senses that something is not right. Another great feature for this printer, and a pretty important feature mostly if you're a beginner like me, is the auto leveling that the printer does all by itself. So you don't actually have to level the bed yourself. With a lot of videos that I've seen online, people would always have to level the bed before doing a print. Well, this printer does everything itself, so you don't even have to go through the trouble of doing that manually. And as I said, for a beginner, that's very important because you don't want to add more extra steps to the printing process because, well, it is a bit overwhelming at first when you get a 3D printer. So having all these features makes your experience better, basically allows you to concentrate on the actual printing, on the projects that you want to print and so on. Controlling the printer is also pretty simple. So first of all, we have a 4.3 inches touchscreen right on the printer here, so you can change settings from here, you can control the printing process from here. So if you're next to the printer, this is very convenient to use. Then we have the AnkerMake apps, so you can install that app on your smartphone and you can control the printer for pretty much anywhere you are. So you don't necessarily have to be next to the printer, you can just do anything you want from that AnkerMake app that's on your smartphone. And of course, there is also a slicer app available for Windows and Mac. Personally, I've only used that for my Mac, so I haven't actually installed it on a Windows machine. But once again, it is super easy to use. You basically drag your project into the slicer there and you press print and that's about it. So extremely easy to get anything done with this printer. The printing quality is awesome on pretty much every project that we've done. And imagine that you have something at home that you can make pretty much anything. So the other day I needed a scraper. I'm not gonna tell you what the scraper was for, but I need the scraper. I was like, oh, I have to go to the store and look for a scraper. But then I was like, huh, let me just print myself a scraper. So you can pretty much think of something that you need, and you can just have it ready in half an hour, or depending how big the project is. Of course, some take longer than other. But yes, you have the power to pretty much think of something, and a little while later, it's right there in your hands. From the screen here, of course, as I said, you can change anything about the printer and you can even get software updates. So I actually got two software updates for the period that I've had this. So the first software update was just when I got it out of the box, and the second one was a couple of days ago. So this is the firmware that we currently have on it. So very, very easy to use. With that camera that we have on the side there, the printer can also do time lapses for every print that you make. So you can basically have a time lapse saved on your phone and then you can share that on social media, if you wanna do that, of course. So to quickly conclude this video, as a beginner 3D printing user, I was blown away by how easy it was to actually set this up and start printing. Literally within half an hour of getting the box, I was able to set this up and start printing right away. You basically just have to put the filament in and then the printer does pretty much everything for you. And then you basically think of something and next thing you know, you have whatever you thought of in your hand. That easy. So it's mind-blowing that we live in this age where you can think of something and an hour later you can actually have that in your hand. As always, I will leave a link to this printer in the video's description if you wanna check it out. Alright guys, if you do have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below. And of course, if I know the answer to your question, I will definitely answer it. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.